this at a point where the Ministry of Internal Affairs, through the National Cooperation Office for the Prevention of Trafficking in Persons, says online sex exploitation is on the increase in the country. According to the 2020 National Report on Countering Trafficking in Persons, more children are apparently now able to access pornography online and as such fall victim to acts of sex exploitation. Let's have the details in the following report.
The newly released 2020 National Report on Countering Trafficking in Persons has revealed 214 incidents of trafficking registered from January to December 2020, a decrease of 15.1% compared to 252 cases registered in 2019. The report further shows that amid the COVID-19 pandemic, incidents of internal trafficking were registered highest.
Illegal and unguided labor migration was the most contributing factor for trafficking of Ugandans to foreign countries and also foreign nationals, because trafficking only doesn't happen for Ugandans who are traveling abroad, but Uganda is also used as a transit country but also a destination. And the majority of the victims were recruited through deceptive means and by the use of forged documents. So some of these traffickers forged documents, not like the ones you see at passport office, but to move their victims. And during lockdown, there was enhanced deployment, if you may recall, for security personnel.
The Deputy National Coordinator for Prevention of Trafficking in Persons, Agnes Igoye, explains that labor was the biggest form of exploitation for trafficking in persons, driven by the large population of unemployed youth and increased demand for semi-skilled labor countries such as Dubai, Abu Dhabi, Oman and Jordan. Over 167 people were trafficked internally, while 395 persons were trafficked to other countries.
The biggest forms, you know, of trafficking were labor exploitation, where internally we had 167 cases, and then transnational, 395. Then there was sexual exploitation, 60 internal. And then one, we had the rituals. You know, there's also trafficking for rituals. You've seen the heads moving around, you know, where they cut off heads of children, where these, you know, to commit these rituals. We had 14 cases. We had forced child labor marriages, which we are 7. We also had forced marriage, 3. And then other forms, child adoption, organ harvesting, we had a case.
Igoye further expressed concern with the new trend of e-learning, which exposes children and other learners to online sex exploitation.
People are going online. Now that our children are studying online, many people are working online. But as your child is studying, the traffickers are also looking for ways to prey on them. Pornography, that's the main use, one main thing they do, pornography, children, but also adults. So let us be vigilant.
Meanwhile, the Ministry of Internal Affairs is developing a national curriculum for those intending to seek employment abroad. The curriculum will clearly outline what is required in the pre-departure orientation for those traveling for work abroad.
So that you know what to expect, that cleaning is actually going to clean. Because if you're a teacher and you're going to go and be a housemaid or a domestic worker, because I don't like the word even housemaid, it's a domestic worker, you know? It means that, okay, how do you prepare yourself? Even me and you, I don't know about you, but whenever, before I travel, I have to find out the climate, you know, what food, you know, to eat, the language, you know, the culture of the people where you're going, how to save your money, okay? How to save your money when you go. Where to seek medical help, which embassy to go to. If you have a complaint, how do you channel it? Because even relationships, you know, with the people you are working with, it's even like a work environment. There's orientation, isn't it?
The same report indicated that last year, 97 cases of human trafficking were prosecuted, out of which 7 cases secured convictions. Many are still pending. This report was compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news in Kampala.